Guys, we are working our way 7 minutes from now. Bragging rights, Illinois and Missouri. There's a good look at Marcus Dedmon. Is almost 17 points per game. That's coming up 7 minutes from now. Should be a heck of a game.
There will be no peace and happiness for only the winning side in the battle for Busch Bragging Rights, the annual rivalry game. It is renewed tonight between number 10 Missouri and number 21 Illinois. Hi again, everyone. Bob Wischuk. And they can both carry their respective teams when asked.
Well, Marcus Dedmon of Missouri, I mean, he's been terrific from three-point range all year. A streaky score that can also put the ball on the floor and penetrate.
Missouri, now neither team is all that strong in the front court. Neither team rebounds it terribly well. Ricardo Ratliff has to carry that load for the Tigers.
You want to look at that guy because they're going to try to establish him down low on the post. He's a junior college transfer.
Chance to start in the front court.
I like this move. He should have started at the beginning of the year. He's a guy that can rebound. He can run the floor. He can also score down low in the paint. That's what Illinois needs.
He will start at point guard, but Michael Dixon is back tonight. He's not starting, but he'll play. He's been out the last couple of games, suspended for violating team rules, but one point guard back in, another out. Dixon's returning, but Mizzou is still shorthanded because Phil Pressey, their freshman phenom at point guard, has a fractured finger. He'll be out at least a couple of weeks. Under 500 for 3 years before he took over on the Tiger sideline. By his third year, Missouri won 31 games, their first ever Big 12 title. Back to that point again. And the same can be said of Bruce Weber. His eighth year at Illinois, he was the National Coach of the Year back in 2005. A 37 court in Champaign. A terrific scene here with Kim English.
Yeah, but Missouri is lucky. They've got to do a better job boxing out. Good move, Dedmon.
Dedmon can't hit with the follow by Lawrence Bowers. Well, if you're going to tie the game at two, you might as well do it in style.
Missouri loves to get out in transition, and Marcus Dedmon is a guy that can create his own shot, and he gets it to the rim, and Lawrence Bowers, second point guard in the lineup. Michael Dixon out there on the floor, missed the last two games, suspended for violating team rules. You can see he's the guy that made the pass down over to Carter Ratcliffe for a point underneath the. And you can see his passing ability to find the freshman, Jeremy Richmond, underneath the basket for the two.
English knocks down a pull-up jumper, and all of a sudden the team's now starting to heat up a bit from the floor. English, wraparound pass.
I think he can be really effective, and here you see Kim English being able to penetrate in that zone, and man, Lawrence Bowers for Illinois offensively getting second chance opportunities, but you have to get back the pass by Dixon to the only senior from Missouri.
Chance for a three-point play for Justin Safford when we come back. Dixon drives it into traffic, lays it off, and able to knock it down inside was Steve Moore.
And that's one of the things that I like about
that. Wound well under 10 seconds. English tries a three. He's got it.
Huge issue for Missouri all year. This is a team that can play, but can they rebound? Can they rebound in the Big 12 again?
For Illinois.
And another reason why Illinois is putting an emphasis on trying to drive the basketball is they don't do a good job of drawing fouls. They only go to the line 17 times a game. And look at the size and that. So his ability to get into the lane not only enables him to score.
Was suspended the last couple of games for a violation of team rules. That was all that Missouri would say about why he was out. Now, when he was out, they outscored. Ratliff, yeah, shuffled his feet inside. Illinois fans looking for a travel. Instead, Ratliff gets the layup.
Some quality wins. They've beaten Maryland, Gonzaga, Oakland.
Ouch. Not only is that going to be goaltending on Bowers, but Bowers undercut by Kim English, and he hit the deck hard and landed. Step aside for just a moment. Scary fall for Lawrence Bowers.
Illinois has got to recognize where the advantage is. And once again, they have Mike Davis down low on the
do as Lawrence Bowers able to shake it off. Dixon hands a pair at the free throw line. Fouls on Illinois. So both teams are over the limit. Denman's been quiet here in the first half. Makes a play there, though, as he shovels it underneath to Bowers.
And a poor low percentage shot for Illinois in a half-court set.
Denman hits a three off the feed from Kim English. And we are tied at 27 with the shot clock turned off. And then a takeaway inside by Dixon, but he lost it right.
Last year, only one ball handler. That was Demetri Agbemi, same time this year.
3 seconds to go. Denman shovels it off. Dixon, good if it counts. Good if it goes, pardon me. And he comes up short. So we will start the second half where we began the first half. Deadlocked in St. Louis. Missouri and Illinois tied at 27. And this is what tied it a moment ago. Marcus Denman finally gets on the board. That was his first field goal. As we send the Jewelers halftime report. Missouri averaging about 86 points a game so far this year. Illinois averaging over 77 a game. And Dixon hits a triple to open up the second half and give Missouri the lead. Read the entry pass, took it away. And now Denman able to score. 5 quick points out of the locker room for Missouri. They end. That jumper goes for Kim English. Another three. Some shots go down for the Tigers in the second half.
Well, Marcus Denman leads the team in scoring, and this was his first basket right before the first half ended. And we talked about him being a streaky scorer, but now everybody's getting involved. You see Marcus Denman put the ball on the floor, showing his versatility. And then Kim English, another guy that can stroke it from the outside, already in the...
Ricardo Ratliff was a first-team junior college All-American. The last American twice. Larry Johnson, probably about as well known as anyone that's ever done it. Matt Cressy was also a junior college.
Range put the ball on the floor, but he does an excellent job of rebounding from the guard position and just continuing to get better on the defensive end. Catch and shoot and those driving opportunities, especially in transition for Marcus Denman.
Well, Denman's a much more dynamic player now than he was. The drive by Cressy. Hands back with Cressy. And he's able to hit the baby jumper. Matt Cressy, who went out of the game early.
I think their schedule is too difficult. They travel too much. Elias Harris, their go-to guy's not 100%. And then Xavier's trying to find a go-to scorer. So really talented basketball.
English drives. Finds Safford. Knocks it down.
That's one of the areas that Kim English has.
Another jumper for Safford.
Defensively, if you're Illinois, you have to take that away. And I'm really surprised at Illinois because their ability to score down there in the paint, and Justin Safford is feeling it offensively, and Illinois needs to usher. This year has been up and down, but he's a tough defender, a rebounder, a glue guy, and
Justin Safford again.
Safford! I see you, big fella.
McCamey hits a triple.
Well, they found the sway from. Put the ball on the floor and take it to the rim.
Safford inside finds Ratliff. And we're tied again. What a terrific basketball game. Bowers lobs it to Ratliff. Nice seal on the backside as he was able to wall off Mike Davis. Watch the screen from Davis. McCamey with the shot clock at 5. Hits a 3. Denman floats one inside to Bowers, and he somehow, with some English, able to squeeze it off the glass and through, and it's a one-point game. Dixon finds Denman. Denman, tough shot, and he hits! Announcer Jinx gets Mike Tisdale. Seconds to play in a tie game. Dixon scoops it and hits off the window.
They have haven't been able to stop them all game.
Paul just about has his pocket picked at midcourt. And then a timeout is granted to Illinois. Bruce Weber saw Brandon Paul in trouble, and he called timeout just before it's knocked away. He's leaning in and asking for a timeout. John Higgins did have his eye on the basketball. You could see Higgins is looking across, actually kind of had his head turned. I thought John Higgins was looking at Brandon Paul.
Ability to create shots for his teammates, and he's been able to get the ball into the lane. His dribble penetration found Marcus Denman for the wide open jump shot in this situation, reading the defense, doesn't pass, takes the ball all the way to the hoop, and despite his size, he's able to finish over a 7 foot.
16 to shoot for Illinois, and they are out of timeout, so they have to try and get it in, and Denman gets the steal, leaves it for Ratliff, and his layup goes. Tim English.
Well, you can see Illinois, they're trying to get the ball to the one guy and the only guy that can handle the basketball. That's Dimitri Magami, and Marcus Denman, once again, all season has come up with
a steal in the backcourt, though, by Davis. Richardson for three. He's got it. It's a one-point game. Quickly the other way. Bowers plus the foul. Intentional foul as well. I think
he does such a good job, even after made basket, pushing the ball ahead and found Lawrence Bowers underneath the basket for an and-one situation.
And that's a tough call. The intention might have been there for Tisdale, giving a little bit of a shove to the back of Bowers. And the ball on top of the made bucket. We're talking about a borderline game-ending call.
Shooting team.
Denman, back door. A six-point trip for Missouri. Higgins warned him and then gave him a tee.
Line and knocking down their free throws.
And pick up the technical foul.
Bowers, there was no way he was going to be able to block the shot. Maybe let him go. You're only down by three, a lot of time to go.
NCAA tournament went 10-6 of the Big 12. But with this win tonight, they're off to an 11. Missouri closes the game on a 21-7 run.
Missouri has been so impressive. They were undersized, undermanned without Phil Pressey. They stepped it up on both ends of the floor and came away with a huge rivalry win.
And Missouri gets the win. For Hubert Davis, I'm Bob Wischusen. So long from St. Louis. Coming up next, Holiday Hoops presented by K Jewelers continues with Xavier taking on Gonzaga. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Now let's go to David Fleming.
So they played it at a neutral site. We got less than 2 minutes to go. We're tied. This was a ball game. Michael Dixon, his friends, they call him Mr. Glass. Next, Fighting Illini possession. Brandon Paul misses the second of two free throws. Missouri going to get with the rebound. Mike Davis going to steal it from Dixon.
Points on 6 of 9 shooting against Northern Illinois. And a couple of high-flying, electrifying dunks. And a rout, 97-61. But tonight, it gets a little bit tougher. The Tigers are off to their best start in 21 years at 12-1. They'll take on a team that's probably headed to the NCAA tournament. They were there a year ago. The Monarchs of Old Dominion. Benny the miss. Marcus Denman, who's been outstanding this year, pulls it away for the Tigers. Denman in the lane. Can't count it. rebound the basketball, but they send four guys to the offensive glass, which should create some opportunities for the Tigers to get out in transition. Watch this little hot step in the lane. Little sidestep, avoids the charge, and gets the finish. Old Dominion, their best ball handler, Darius James, is going to play a lot of minutes in that real difficult one to swallow. Here's Pressey. Off the glass. Matt Pressey. Pressey again. Nice lead underneath the Ratliff.
Well, I think Matt Pressey's decision-making has gotten so much better with minutes a game. I think he's done exactly what Mike Anderson would want him to do.
Ratliff from the baseline. Shooter's touch.
So you haven't seen a lot of that, though.
Most of, you know, he shoots 55% from the floor. Here's Dixon. Led the team an assist a year ago. Gives it to Deadman. 4-3.
You know, I just think things work better when Michael Dixon's in the game. Secondary break. It's not a classic fast break, but Dixon does a nice job. He knows right where Marcus Deadman is. He gave it to him right in his shooting pocket. He could step right into that. Didn't have to hesitate because he gets to the rim.
Here's Pressey again in the lane. Contact and cut.
I'm telling you, Matt Pressey is playing with tremendous, tremendous confidence, and that is his game. Going to the basket. And he was doing this earlier in the year, but he wasn't able to finish. He does a nice job kind of sliding by the defense, getting the contact, but he's what he's been able to.
0 for 2 from the free throw line, and now he's on rebound.
And a good shot, and a good find by Michael Dixon. That's a great shot.
Pressey underneath. Wow!
He's been good finishing at the rim.
10:40 to go. After the miss by Kreklow, Pressey up and under. 17-14.
So every day in practice, every game, he fights some minutes.
A different look defensively by Old Dominion. Pressey steps up and hits the two. James Madison, Oscar, wrestled one at Louisville this year. Deadman for three. Kenny English hits the three.
Boy, did he need that for his confidence.
Inside to Ratliff. Deadman for three.
How about that Boston? He just froze everybody on Old Dominion. They thought he was going to reverse the basketball. The whole defense has shifted.
Here's Deadman. Off the glass, no good. Somehow got it back in his hands and finished.
Give credit to Justin Safford. He kept it alive. But
finds Deadman for three. No, Safford kept it alive. Ratliff inside.
I'll tell you what, you got to credit that to Justin Safford on both ends of the floor. He is playing with great toughness. And the last two offensive rebounds they've gotten were because of Justin Safford.
Watch the shot go up, and Safford attacks the glass, gets a hand on it, goes right back to Deadman. He won't get an assist for that one, but it certainly was an assist. And there he does, gets another hand on it, gets it to his teammate, Ratliff. Two great plays by Justin Safford. That's the type of toughness that we're trying to play. There's Dixon for three. That's his fifth three. The Tigers have hit. Most of his damage done in the first 10 minutes, and right away, right around his defender. Many times we say it goes down to the wire with Mizzou. And as I say that, with 31 on the shot clock, Deadman says, all right, I'll take it. Hits a three. Safford to the trailer. Ratliff off the glass and good.
Mike Anderson says, get up, get up. He wants to speed this game up.
Here's English, backing in his man. Step through, look at that by Kimmy English. The second half for the Missouri Tigers. Nifty move here by Kimmy English. Not a Dixon. Dixon loves that floater, this time off the glass.
The offense just runs better when Dixon's in.
Deadman for three. Why not? He hits another. He has been on fire. Marcus Deadman.
Look at how he stepped into this shot. Bazemore does a good job kind of reaching over the screen. Gets a hand up, but the way Deadman's seeing the ball in the basket right now, it's not.
Ratliff working inside to Dixon for three. Yes, his second of the night. Sleeve for Carter. And behind, Ratliff got a piece. Here's English. English all the way in and finishes.
And every shot's contested. Steve Moore gets a piece of that ball. They secure the rebound. And look at how quickly they get the ball out. They look up the court. And English with the great shoot.
I want him to shoot.
Everybody wants him to shoot except my game.
Pressey inside. Dixon. Here's that floater again off the glass.
Did you say that he likes the floater?
Man, oh man.
Pretty good, huh?
Kevin English with it. Dixon again for three. His third of the night.
A little herky-jerky in his delivery, but shooting it well.
They turn it over. There's Dedmon. Marcus Dedmon to finish. Timeout, Monarchs.
Again, just great ball movement against the zone, reversing the basketball. Dixon comes off the baseline in rhythm, catches it, fires it, shooting the ball extremely well tonight. And Marcus Dedmon, as he has all night, taking it aggressively to the basket off the turnover.
Very good decision by Marcus.
Alley-oop, Powers the bus.
As soon as you say, let's pull it back out. Oh, we're going to throw you.
And Powers a steal. And Old Dominion is coming unglued.
Well, Lawrence Powers quiet until this. And seconds later, a steal. And we're talking about this during the break.
Missouri just wears you down.
Ratliff working inside against Cassell. Too easy.
The Tigers win it 81-58 tonight. Missouri, number 10 in the country. They'll go to 13-1. Impressive win.
It was a good effort on both ends. I thought the Tigers really out-toughed a very tough and experienced Old Dominion team. This is a hallmark win for their non-conference season.
The Tigers roll 81-58. Much more to come from Mizzou Arena. We've got the post-game show. 30 minutes of breaking this one down with stats, highlights, gets. Tiger Hoops Rewind coming up. 81-58, the final tonight.
Thanks very much. Great finish in Louisville. What a win for Rick Pitino's team. They come all the way in quick. Left his feet, Ratliff. And the jump hook will go for Ricardo Ratliff.
Now, Ricardo Ratliff on that right hand, he broke a finger. He's playing really good basketball in September, in December.
And one, Matt Pressey. Done a lot of damage on the perimeter, but first Ratliff.
Well, Ratliff's done a nice job inside, John. And then the ball movement, Kim English knocks down a three. Marcus Dedmon in transition gets one to go. He's been red hot as of late. And it's been a very solid performance so far by Mike Anderson's team.
Krecklow is checked in. He has the ball and now gives off. Pressey. And Matt hits the jumper. He's off to a good start.
Matt Pressey. Right? No, you're exactly right. Missouri is fastest 40 minutes in basketball, John, right? Average 85 points a game. Turn teams over. They get 23 points a game off turnovers. And this style's been very effective for Mike Anderson throughout his career. It's all about creating a fast tempo off your defense. They've done that well, so move the defense side to side and exploit a driving opportunity.
English able to hit.
Preston Knowles, by the way, playing great for the Cardinals right now.
Dixon finds Ratliff inside. He's been tough to handle.
You know what he does? He's patient, but he fits nicely into that grind it out, full court style. Look at that. That's really good low post play, John, because he's doing it. He's one of those guys that he's there not play. Is all Mike Anderson needs from the young big guy from Kansas City.
Well, Missouri has responded to the Aggie here in the first half. And yet, Missouri shooting 55% from the floor. Little crossover there, left-handed scoop, plus the foul.
And what you like about that play, John, is a lot of driving opportunity. There it is. That's the end of the possession. The bow doesn't get there in time, and Denman's able to finish. But this was set up because of ball movement.
Well, that's Matt Pressey, nice.
Really nice
move.
That was great side-to-side.
Dedmon. Not able to hit. Loose ball. Ratliff underneath. Puts it in. Oh, Ricardo Ratliff doing big time work down low. And Missouri gets a bucket as the half comes to a close. But A&M, after trailing
both numbers.
Middleton and Walkup, the dynamic duo in the first half. Missouri starts with the ball, and inside it's Justin Safford with his first point of the game.
The 3 o'clock in the afternoon three-point shot right there.
English able to answer. Kim English shooting 40.
This team is ranked where they are, even though they don't have the high-profile names.
Oh, Denman spins it home. Marcus Denman. Denman using the Safford screen. Little floater. Rolls that one home. He's got 9. Dixon, good feed, and Ratliff lays it in. He's got a dozen.
That ball went from one side of the 50 feet to the other side. And that
here at Reed Arena, where A&M has won 41 of its last 44, and a big triple by Dixon.
We talk about family affair in this game with the Presseys, sons of Paul Pressey. Three-time leading scorer here at Texas A&M.
He's actually, Robertson was going to come, what, 2 years ago instead.
That's pretty good.
Bowers spinning, good look underneath, and Ratliff able to put that one in.
Who's that double team, John?
Hibbert a 3. They just have moved the ball so well, finding the open man, Aggie Lee. Denman posting, can't hit, Ratliff underneath. Offensive rebound and a putback. 17 now for Ricardo Ratliff.
A marvelous job in his first year after coming over from Cornell.
Flip Pressey from deep, but he knocks it down. Shooting glove and all.
Grinding. Missouri shooting it from deep. Phillip Pressey, son of the...
Aggies continue to assert their dominance on the glass. There's Pressey. Gets another. Flip Pressey making an impact here in the second half.
And he's taking that glove off, John, that wide receiver glove that you talked about.
Here's what it looked like. It's basically a football player glove, and now this is what it's looking like. Great free throw shooter.
This is hard, John. I'm going to tell you now, it's not as easy as you think to make free throws when no one else is on the line. Stephen.
And Pressey gets another.
Well, smart move.
Ratliff buries that one. What a game for Ricardo Ratliff, 19-9.
You know, he reminds me.
A chance to take the lead with a bucket. There's Ratliff underneath. Bowers hanging, and one. Lawrence Bowers will go to the line. And Missouri will in the first half.
How about the interior passing so far between Bowers and Ratliff? Ratliff returns the favor that time. Ratliff did a good job. He realized he didn't have anything at the rim, and he found Bowers at the
board. Denman off the window and good.
That was really smart. Outlet. Denman doesn't see anybody stop the ball, so he very wisely gets to the rim, and look at how he uses the glass. Balance on Missouri's part. 5 different double-figure scorers, but the guy that stirs the drink this year has been Marcus Denman. Been red hot as of lately. He's let the game come to him today, but guess what? He's taking over at the exact right time for Mike Anderson.
Markeith, pretty good player.
Markeith is the unsung Morris twin, because Marcus is so versatile in so many ways, but Markeith.
As he gives off Bowers.
How about that, John?
Man.
That's a freshman. 3 threes in the second half without that wide
receiver. Pressey puts it on the floor. A little floater out of that. Window. Wow.
Now, he was playing like this at the end of December. He went into the phone booth, came out with the tape on the hand, and he's knocking down some threes. Take a look. Calmly, quietly. The last couple possessions. Screens don't matter if you switch well.
Harris and one. goes to the line.
Would be a bonus for the Aggies.
About 52%, and he gets it. Bowers 70% from the strike. Middleton double teamed, and then Denman retreats. Middleton will go to the line to shoot two. Ricardo Ratliff done for the day. Middleton 82% from the line.
Call timeout, or they can push the ball quickly. There's a sub in this game.
So they get it to Pressey, the freshman. Phil Pressey has been brilliant in the second half. Pressey hanging, can't hit. And we're going to have overtime. Flip Pressey, shot contested. And A&M with some excellent defense, 77 apiece. And we'll go to OT.
Well, that's the right play. You want to put the onus.
Missouri trailed at the break by 7. And the Aggies control. So Mike Anderson's team, not real big to begin with. Next year on ESPN2, Jackson State and Texas Southern. We'll bring it to you as soon as this one ends. And Flip Pressey in the second half. What a job he's done.
Is he feeling it? And trying to get that second win back.
Denman hangs and hits. Marcus Denman absorbs the contact.
Well, in a sense, he has rested the last few possessions because of the way Philip Pressey has been aggressive. But that is a big play. Watch him get body to body, draw the contact, and hang and use the glass.
English with a pull-up, got it.
Boy, big shot. You know what? Middleton's gas, too.
Middleton on English, little fadeaway.
Back at you. Scouting report team.
Denman catch and shoot.
Boy, did Lawrence Bauer set that up? He got to the paint.
Mike Anderson has lost both Steve Moore and Ricardo Ratliff.
Keep your eye on walk-up now. He's rebounded big plays. They make the basket. He's had some big.
He lost the ball. Middleton now. Lays it in.
Marcus Denman needed to pull that ball off. That was a critical mistake. Possession.
Pressey had it knocked away. A&M comes up with it. And they foul Middleton.
I'd like to see this because P.J. Holmes is a really good. There's the drive. Well, it's hard to tell from there, John. Right, let's take a look at it now. He's coming at you. To be honest, I can't tell from that angle. No.
Dixon almost threw it away. Did throw it away. Four-point game. Pressey can't spin it home. That'll count. And that is that. Mark Turgeon in overtime. His Texas A&M Aggies win a tough one. 90.
And Sean, two ranked teams meeting here. And what?
In the half court is motion offense. All five players touching it. See, this is not how I think they wanted to start. Even though Ratliff was effective inside, we had hand-to-hand combat. Almost 60 fouls called. And both teams. So right now, Missouri's offense is way out of control. This is not how they normally play in the half court.
Ratliff with the basket. He's got all four.
Dixon ahead to Denman. Denman will take it in for the jam.
That's more Tiger-like right there. This
and now Paul Pressey. Both will see action. Phil and Matt on the floor right now as the three goes for English's 35th triple.
To 15. We had lost power temporarily, and now the power is back. That three goes for Missouri and give. Hi, Carl Ravitch, back in our ESPN College Basketball Studios. Always on your toes around here with Missouri now leading.
Missed three from Denman, but he got it back. And a good look inside. And the bucket for Bauer.
I watched Safford at the point of
those coming in overtime, including at Texas A&M on Saturday, as the three goes for Michael Dixon, the fourth three of the first.
Junior Walk-on
is getting some opportunities to play as Denman goes back door and gets the layup.
Now keep your eye on 21 Bauer. You look at Michael Dixon now, the backdoor cut. Denman, who has got to be played at the three-point line. And Jacob Pullen not watching the ball like he should. Easy back cut.
Interesting, Jacob Pullen, after a recent Kansas State loss, said that if the Wildcats play in the NIT, remember this
postseason tournament Kansas State plays in, Jacob Pullen will finish a phenomenal career where he's all right now fourth in scoring all time.
Clock to fourth for Kansas State. But Missouri keeps possession and hits another three. Justin Sessions. In overtime, the Texas A&M on Saturday had 16 points, 4-4 from three. Here's his brother, Matt Pressey, with a two-point basket.
It's on selfish plays in basketball.
And Spradling's a 40% three-point shooter. Could have easily taken that one, but gave it up as Bowers. 8 points now for Bowers, 4-4. If it didn't look there on the replay like Spradling touched it, but that was the call, and Missouri gets a bucket as Presley going to the basket, gives the Tigers an 11-point lead.
They'll get out, extend, and deny, but when you do that, you've got to have an antidote today for the Tigers. Little back. Of course, he's part of Mike Anderson's family. Look at that.
Right to the bucket again, right on cue is Flip Presley. He's got 10 points off the...
That's always been a problem with them, as good as they are, and they're awfully good. You know, you've got to...
UCLA and USC and Nebraska and Iowa State. But are the Jayhawks still the best team in the Big 12?
Well, they are. Mike Anderson not happy with that.
4 seconds to go. Good play by Pressey to knock it loose. Magruder able to catch and fire, and that ends the half. Bill Pressey becoming a star before our eyes. A career-high 16 points against A&M on Saturday. 10 points in 9 minutes here today. And Missouri leads Kansas State by 5
turnovers, and it's because they've got very quick hands, especially in the backcourt. You're talking about guys like Dixon and the Presseys, Marcus Denman, Ricky Kreklo. They get after you, they tip it from behind, and it usually leads to offense at the other end. This is where the fastest 40 minutes comes in. Martin, I would have loved to have heard his halftime talk, because his team came out and answered.
Bill Presley promptly hits a three, didn't start the second half. And Pullen took a shot to the face. 5-on-4 for the Tigers. Denman to the bucket, able to get it to go over Henriquez Roberts.
Well, Denman should be first. Points a game, and he does it in only 12 shots a game. He's a very efficient. Best thing to do right now is make sure he gets back 100% healthy.
Ratliff leaning in, gets the basket. Meanwhile, is Baylor Frame one of the more disappointing teams?
But they must move the ball in the half court. That's their best offense.
Dixon off the window. American makes it a three-point game. English back down court, got caught in the air, but before he came down and traveled, he handed it off to Ratliff.
That time.
Pressey to English, knocks down a three. Came in shooting 39% from out there.
Really a guy you see in here that's knocking down shots in practice. It's number 24 in white. Youngster from Baltimore.
Pressey. And now Denman, a wide open three, got it.
How about that? That's called hustle right there. They came up with the extra possession. Hustle, but unfortunate for Kansas State.
And three free throws. Kansas State had it down to three, but the lead back to eight now for Mizzou. Pressey, 4-on-2. Pressey, the lob, the finish by Bowers!
Watch the quick hands now by Pressey. I want you to watch his eyes right now. He's taking a look. He's certain with a 7-foot-1 wingspan running to the rim. So I'll place it up on a tray like a server in a restaurant. Watch his eyes. Perfect. Need to be now.
English on the drive. Beautiful move by Kim English. Hanging and finishing.
all the various styles of play offensively and defensively seen throughout the course of an 18-game schedule.
And the way George received.
Led the nation in steals and turnovers forced a year ago. They're up there again this year. The country in assists, fifth in scoring entering this week. Free throws for English, and the lead is 15.
In the country a year ago, and in a year with so many outstanding freshman point guards, guys like Brandon Knight come.
He's having a lot more fun watching this team than watching his own. Paul Cressy. Their other loss was at Colorado. The Buffaloes still unbeaten in conference play as Dixon gets the first free throw for Mizzou.
For Big 12 Player of the Year, Jordan Hamilton's been outstanding. Rick Barnes, his team has great chemistry. Big game made a year ago. Quality kids 2 years ago in 09.
Fastest Missouri coach to 100 wins. And how about a 17-4 run to end the game? Kansas State got within three. With about 8 minutes to go, it was all Missouri after that. 75-59, the Tigers win. Big Monday presented by Bud Light continues next from Pittsburgh. Syracuse and Pitt, number 3 versus number 4 coming up. For Fran Fraschilla, I'm Dave Pasch. So long from Columbia, Missouri. This has been an exclusive presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Now to Dan Shulman in Pittsburgh.
Denman and company are hoping to get an upset win on the road. He's averaging 16 and a half per game this season, leading his team, coming off a 17-point effort in a big win over Colorado.
This is Lawrence, one of the most storied venues in basketball, the Fog Allen Fieldhouse, and they take on their arch rival, the Kansas Jayhawks. Good evening.
From it, he went in and got the bucket.
Marcus Denman from Kansas City puts the Tigers on.
Keep doing that, but they have had patience. Although they've turned it over twice, their offensive patience is going to be important to them in this game.
Kicks back to Denman, the three ball, just short, front of the iron. Offensive put back by Ratliff, and that is huge if they're going to get offensive rebounds here.
No question, because the two.
Bauer spin move baseline, beautiful into the paint that time out.
Oh, it makes Kansas play defense, which
great
is huge.
Pass and Bowers again, but what a pass from Flip Cressy.
Cressy took that drive.
Three ball launched and it's on target from Ricardo Ratliff, a junior from Hampton, Virginia.
Good rebounding.
Bowers fades it. We could have one brewing here.
You know, right.
Now Dixon running the point. Dixon penetrates, throws it up. Offensive rebound and a putback for Ricardo. Tyrell Reed committed his first personal. You know, Bob, last year we were here.
They're in. They've made Kansas work on defense, and the more you have to work on defense, it's almost.
As coach pointed out, because of the pace of this game, Dixon forces the throw and knocks it down. How about that under pressure from Johnson? Respond that Dixon will. Dixon's knocked down his last two shots, five quick
three or four times. But in doing so, they've gotten a couple of buckets and a drop-off pass for a basket. They've only had one time, Brett, where they forced something and drawn a charging foul or thrown the ball away, taking it to the bucket. They had a couple of bad turnovers early, but their offense has been really good. Here's Safford, makes a little fake, looks, finds Dixon alone at the top of the key, and really good work, Dixon coming into shot position.
Jay Hart trailed once by six, and now they've cut it to four.
And the baseline becomes a great defensive player.
And kicks it inside now. Ratliff up over the top. He's 4 of 4 from the floor. There is the young man, number one. He'll fire the three. Yes. Oh, boy. Here. And take a look at young Pressy. Give me that much room, I'll make you pay for it. Timeout in Lawrence. Long time in the NBA. Some of it, of course, with the Milwaukee Bucks. And he was an outstanding scoring guard for them and also could throw the ball. But watch him back down. That's Pops. And now his two boys who grew up calling Mike Anderson Uncle Mike are now Matt, a junior, played at a JC and transferred in. And the youngster, Phil, his point guard, comes in here with that average on the season. And again, great bounce pass. And the other Pressey. Matt Pressey drives through for the layup. His first field goal.
He's back from that bad shot and delivers a really good pass right here off the bounce. Look, under, past the defender, and takes it away from the block.
With nine. From the right baseline, a big shot by Bowers.
The game is not nearly as smooth as when the two Morrises are in there.
What a drive. Score the field goal. Here's the big body Moore. Kicks to a wide open Bowers and it stays down. Big field goal for Lawrence.
If Kansas would have gotten the ball back here without any Missouri scoring, then he drops both of them in. That gives him a much better chance going in at the half than if there had not been a foul.
Hit the front end, Conley, that's three in a row at the free throw line.
Down into the bucket, the arc. Really a nice release, look at that, great release.
He shot it right back in with those four free throws, trailer by one.
Absolutely.
Coming out of the last 2 minutes. They'll look for a score. And they got it. Out of Lawrence Bowers from the right corner. In and off the bench, huge field goal. 3.9, gotta hurry now. Down four from midcourt. It's wrong.
The shot fake. I love to see the shot fake, and that was a huge bucket for the Jayhawks.
Success of putting the ball on the floor and penetrating and getting into the lane. Look at the freshman, Phil Pressey, split the defense, get the ball down low to athletic, versatile, power forward Lawrence Bowers up and under, and then once again, gets the ball, puts the ball on the floor. He does a terrific job of pass first point guard.
Down the floor they come. Pressey! And Bowers finishes it. What a look away lob.
Control. Here's where Pressey looks away, as Brent said, and makes a great lob pass.
Flip sends it back outside to Denman. Denman penetrates. Denman rolls it in.
And
Kansas. Now Denman attacks after the timeout and rolls it in. Coach.
Well, I don't know why possession.
Pull up, young Pressey answers with a three.
Ice water for a freshman, ice water.
you don't have to worry about what the score is. My guys just took a bad shot.
Take another one, knock it. He'll run the Tigers. Denman fires up a three ball, his first three of the game. So he's... Safford steps out. He misses. Bowers, strong offensive rebound. A wraparound's good. Good offensive rebound.
Well, that was a great rebound. This can cut it from 9-7. Now, there it's 8. And it was just... Ev smacked him in the head with a forearm. That's just not necessary.
Here's Safford again. That's a two.
That's a big bucket right there.
Probably sporting her shirt in enemy territory.
It seems like Ray has been very careful rather than great plays, and I think they got themselves in a real deep hole to start with. And then, you know, the other thing that has to happen, a great job of doing that.
Yeah. I've got my first Super Bowl prediction. Do you want to hear it?
Pressey attacks. A blocking foul.
See it here. Watch there. Watch him get set. Great body control again. Moving it.
Grew up calling Mike Anderson Uncle Mike. You think any other team had a chance to recruit? I don't think so.
Up
66 on him. The three ball knocked down by Phil Pressey. Kansas has got a chance to hit 100 here tonight. And Pressey will come right with him at the other end. Bowers kicks it back, Ratliff knocks down the three ball.
Pressey. Kansas doesn't want to get sloppy here. They don't want to get lazy on the defensive end. Marcus was a little bit lazy there. Moved too late, banged again.
Got to ask my good buddy Coach Knight a question. And Coach,
it'll be interesting in the next time they play if Kansas and Texas have the same.
And nice fadeaway shot from that right.
I said, no, man, he's a general.
I like him. Hit on the air. They understand
him. Here comes Denman throwing it up and in with the left hand.
Come in and get beat again, and particularly get beat pretty soundly when they were, you know, back and forth.
That'll do it. 12 straight times.
At 19-6 and ranked 21st overall, play host to the Texas Tech Red Raiders. Perfect in the conference. At Missouri, they have won every game.
Question for their season and what their seed will be, assuming they make the NCAA tournament, is can they translate that at something
on that shot? But it's tipped out by English. And a great look at it from Marcus Denman. Denman, who is jabbed in the eye.
Shouldn't he be giving you a ride in the game?
English picks up the loose ball and lays it in off the window.
Men's basketball.
Denman catch and shoot and gets another. That's a two. You get tricked up. Denman, good
nice
look underneath to Bowers.
Hurt, you keep playing. He's playing hurt tonight.
Denman uses the ball fake, puts his, but look at the way he gets his offense here.
It's catch and shoot jump shots. And George Washington never lied. You know what else doesn't lie? Film and stats. And the stats simply are telling the season. Are they in a losing streak? Are they injured? Do you have illness? Well, what about a 6 o'clock start locally? This place is usually a zip.
And now Ratliff up ahead. Dixon off the glass and good. Matt Pressey gives it over to Steve Moore. Back to Safford. And the lefty hits the jumper. Dixon buries a three. Missouri with possession here. And nice ball movement there as it ends up in the hands of Pressey, who lays it in.
Look at the quickness. Like a shot clock's running down. So you take a bad shot. 1,001, 1,002, great baseball pass, and Pressey.
Safford kicks to Kreklow, great shooter. Kreklow's dad is the women's. Moore underneath, and lays it in.
They really like Steve Moore. They really like Moore, and they start turning the basketball over and allowing Texas Tech, who you had dead to rights, back in the game.
And Phil Pressey answers with a three by a deuce.
Now see, Mike Anderson does have good feel.
Denman and one, and he'll go to the line.
As Denman, Missouri's at their best, it's when that ball is moving side to side to side.
Denman, catch and shoot again.
But forget about Iowa State, they need to worry about the task at hand.
Good feed inside. Good arc on that pass. Denman right at the rim and rolls it home. Loose ball, Moore comes up with it. Scramble for that.
Now Marcus Denman. Crockett's been tremendous though, great energy.
Denman hanging and hitting. Marcus Denman, he and Marcus Denman went to junior high together.
Need and remarkable hands. He's the Doge Balbe of Missouri in that he get. And I'm not talking about as a shooter.
Denman catch and shoot.
Nice play.
Lewandowski tips it over to Crockett, who puts it in. Great first half by Pat Knight's Red Raiders. Missouri leads it by
off the bench.
All right, coming up in the second half, Doug Gottlieb will be your analyst. And in that first half with 18 points, doing almost all the damage on catch and shoot. There's Lawrence Babb. And Missouri led by as many as 9. And a bucket there. Kim English with 4. Moore gives off to Pressey. Red Raiders leading it by 2. Pressey a 3. And a timeout called by Missouri. English an open look. And he answers.
I think he needs to. I think Kim English. Now, Kim English, when he gets his feet set, he has the skill set to be a 20-point-a-game guy that's playing within the confines of the offense.
They struggled most in the first half when they had their backups in, much like they have two backups in now.
Safford backing down, and the lefty puts it in. It's 9-a-game. Crackle cuts to the hoop. English, nice speed. Low as steal. And then the foul.
Got to come back and catch it.
Safford with Crockett on him. Turnaround wouldn't go. Ball tipped away. And underneath, Mike Dixon Jr. lays it in. Dixon, fancy dribbling. And rolls that one home.
Not just because they have pretty good shooters, but you make a free throw, it allows them to set up their press with the proper personnel.
Safford. Recklow catch and shoot. High off the glass, it'll go down. For one.
And they've suffered a couple defeats recently as their schedule kind of backloaded.
Denman underneath. Marcus Denman with the bucket. Cressy, Safford with the flush. That's a three. And Cressy able to get it to go.
Just a beautiful pass from Flip Cressy to Justin Safford rolling down the lane. And then the next possession, a little bit overly fancy from Flip Cressy, but he gets the basketball back on balance, in rhythm, bang. And Texas Tech seems to have run out of gas.
Challenge to officials. And Curtis Shaw, who's now in charge of overseeing the Big 12, a former Big 12, see the disparity in free throws. Missouri goes to Oklahoma State, 41-16, Oklahoma State.
Safford backing down and gets it to go. Safford with
68%. They're not coming down taking jump shots. Their press break has been effective.
English, nice move, and goes to the left hand to finish. He's got 13.
Now, I almost think you have to take him out if he doesn't take to his man. That's where Texas Tech has been able to shoot layups and dunks.
The lead is a dozen. Dixon pull up. Nice move. Denman aggressively. Ratliff the putback. Robertson hit the deck, wanted the call and didn't get it. An 11-2 run. English backing down. Nice play. Bowers in and out. Bowers puts it in.
That Missouri got the ball to English. English creates. Orange Bowers needs some of that oil. Felt like the Tin Man, I'm sure. School, they use a Nike basketball. Not all schools use coinciding basketballs like this year or next year. You got everybody back but one player. Most probably going to have to, first they got to win the road. They did win at Kansas State. But if they can beat a Texas at home,
it could go in the first half, and they really dug in.
It shows that there is some fight left in them. Whereas you get to this point in the season, three seniors, sometimes teams don't fight. So they didn't fight tonight. Missouri just dynamic in this place. We'll see if they can go undefeated and beat Kansas end of this year.
Tigers are perfect 16-0 here at Mizzou Arena. Win it tonight, 92-84 the final. Up next here on ESPN2, it's NBA Coast to Coast. A reminder over on ESPN and ESPNU. More college hoops, Michigan State and Ohio State.
Three, and much of that's due that Iowa State only has seven scholarship players. And you throw in the fact that Jamie Vanderbeeken, who missed the A&M game, game probably out today as well, so they're even more thin. But it's the pressure, the constant changing of defenses that you get from Missouri. Marcus Denman, terrific about getting in the passing lanes. This team produces points off turnovers, and they get them in runs. Iowa State, particularly Deontay Garrett from that point guard.
And the resilient Cyclones of Iowa State will need it today against 21st-ranked Missouri as the Tigers look for their first road. They only have 11 scholarship players available. Senior Jamie Vanderbeeken is missing his third straight game with an ankle injury. They have really...
They're going to use 10, and you'll see majority of those 10 in the first half.
And you'll see Lawrence Bowers scoring right away. Coast to coast after getting the board.
Anderson is really the heart and soul of Iowa State, a player that arguably is a leading rebounder in the country. He's got to be rebound. Long shot means long rebounds. Bowers in perfect position, got it, went straight up, didn't try to force the
practice that one thing that the Cyclones have to do is take care of the ball.
Yeah, I mean, that's what Missouri's going to try to do is turn you over. But more important
is the one who's getting the start with Vanderbeeken injured. Look at how Missouri pushes it. Look at Denman get up the floor and draw the block.
And with hard work, nice crossover, attacking the basket. The defender just was there too late. And
one of the things about this team has been the absence of some of the senior leadership they've had in years past. And when we talked to Mike Anderson last night, he said that the thing that is still so well, 29 straight games now with a three for Christofferson. And in a four-point game, look at Denman get to the hoop. That's what.
Yeah, you're right, Brad. And you can really see the game plan of Coach Anderson wanting to attack the paint, that power portion, and put Iowa State on their heels.
That's nine bounds. Pressey. Good look for Bowers from English. Real good look from English. And timeout. A great look down low from Ratliff inside to Bowers. For Bowers twice in a row now. What's Iowa State have to do to stop that?
Well, Godfrey has to really pay attention. You never lose sight of your have that bench to take people out and say, hey, this is what you're doing wrong. Godfrey probably only be on the bench for a couple minutes. That's what makes it really 9 points from last year. Really done an exceptional job for Iowa State.
Nice perimeter shot by Justin Saffert, a starter a year. Pressey. English, a terrific move to the basket. First field goal. Look at him run. Oh, Christofferson. That was like right out of Butch and Sundance. Who are those guys?
Well, and that's where you... Freshman, he's really done a great job of excelling his game.
Look at Ratliff pull it out of the air. Denman. Oh. 45% threes. Oh my goodness.
Well, Missouri fans know that whenever
I was getting it done right now for the Tigers.
You got to look at this scattering point, and if you did, you would know that last game he had 18 points in the
best part of the half, brought to you by Advance Auto Parts, where service is our best part. It's Marcus Denman, the leader for the Tigers. And now a foul on
back into this ball game.
That is Denman. That's what he does. The last shot. Good defense by Anderson. Now Boo Boo Paulo will not get a shot, and we've got a tremendous game at halftime where Missouri has only a 2-point lead. Banzer for the Studio 66 half.
Oklahoma, and you got to credit the defense Iowa State is playing.
Ratliff starts the Tigers off with his second bucket. Ratliff back to flip Pressey. Oh, my. That shot was about as long as he had.
And this is just all confidence. He just says, hey, if you're not going to get up on me, you better read the bio because I can get it from down.
And look at him push. 19 for Marcus.
Good player for Iowa State.
Nice shot for Ratliff. And there's no doubt both of these teams have
has ever been around in his entire history of coaching. He should be exciting for the Cyclones next year.
Denman again. Saffert. Oh, he passed up the open shot until he finally again as timeout is called by the time.
Father left San Jose State as a leader. He's the total opposite of his dad. He's a shoot first point guard. Look, Pops, I saw the way you played. You like
bright at Missouri. Those are two very big free throws for Michael.
On the road and done a good job of that tonight.
These are big free throws down the stretch for
the paint because you got to get those easy shots from the charity stripe.
Well, if Missouri holds on and wins, it'll be partly because accomplish. And off the road, Edgem. Under a second. That's gone. And Missouri has broken the road jinx. And
Missouri Arena. And with the month of March just days away, immediacy and urgency gripping both these teams. Number 21, Missouri, coming in at 21-6 overall. It's English, Denton, Ratliff, Phil Pressey, and Lawrence Bowers, who's starting to come on a little bit of late. Mike Anderson, the head coach of the Missouri Tigers, in his fifth season as head coach, recently registering. Flip Pressey throws up the floater. Not sure whether that was a pass or a shot, but Ratliff catches it in. English controls, and Pressey with the handoff for the easy deuce.
And that's one of the things that Baylor creates. They love it.
Jump shot good by Bowers, and Bowers has been coming on. Great ball movement. English got it. Dixon with a nice feed to Ratliff inside. No call on the flop. Safford knocks down the baseline jump shot. You know, it was a year ago on ESPN. And Marquette, a team
Vanderbilt, but they did beat Notre Dame and Syracuse, two ranked opponents in Big East play.
Slob, and AC couldn't corral the ball. Dixon in a rush.
Wow,
he was a blur down the floor.
That's been effective when he's caught the ball down on the post in the first half.
Denman for three. Shows you why he's shooting four.
Ball game, but I'm sure Coach Scott Drew said, let's get it going offensively. We need you out there.
Missouri knocked. And Missouri turns over Baylor again. English with the layup.
They don't have a lot of threat in terms of shoot the ball from the outside of Dunn. So five defenders are looking at the place Darius Dunn. And
another wide open, uncontested look. Ratliff again. Of Nolan Richardson, former assistant coach. Nice speed inside. Safford couldn't convert it. Got it back and got the second one to go.
Didn't stop him.
Dixon knocks down the free throw. Degree, native of Sacramento. Aspirations of becoming an NBA general manager, he told me before the game. But he's the. Here's Starja Love. Love, and you have to love that as a good way to perhaps begin this
on the floor and starting posting up. Look for Dunn to post up the smaller guards in Missouri, try to get to the free throw line.
A 72% foul shooter on the season. Nice to see Bowers bounce back from offseason wrist surgery. Well, we talked about Lawrence Bowers. Hubert, how many times does a collegiate athlete get a chance to throw out the first pitch at a baseball game?
Whoa, Cardinals hold up a second here.
Hey, he painted the black on the outside of the.
This is not a good matchup. Somebody's going to have to get the basketball. Anthony Jones cannot bring up the ball against Phil Pressey.
And they turn it over, and Missouri turns it into an instant bucket.
We talked about
stick back, and here comes Baylor a little bit, down by just 10. Denman with the layup.
Mark, that can't happen. You cannot give an uncontested layup.
Championship. A junior college championship.
One gets up and down the floor. Maybe they should wear be wearing them, right?
Yeah, they should. Hey, sometimes testing jump shots.
Bowers on the baseline, knocks it down. Lawrence Bowers in the last four games coming into
his job against Perry Jones down low in the middle, and then Ricardo Ratliff. Look at Bowers, offensive rebound. Great defense, and then gets the offensive putback here on the offensive end. Power forward center. He's really done a nice job on both ends of the floor, and he's fun to watch. You can see him when they pressure full court, his ability to get into passing lanes and be able to convert, come over. Only at 6'8", he's one of the best shot blockers in the Big 12. His versatility on the offensive end, being able to knock down that 17-foot jump shot, and then also offensive rebound. Perry Jones done a nice job deflections, having a complete game on both ends of the floor. And right on cue, right-hand jump hook in the lane.
Bowers. Nice drive and kick. English knocks down the three. English at 39. There's Denman. Little short corner jump shot good by Lawrence Bowers. Bowers of Missouri's 19 points here in the second half and getting a little bit of help from English.
He is a great jump shot.
There's Denman. On the blow by Denman with a great move and one with a circus finish.
Beginning the game, we talked about Denman, not just a jump shooter. He can put the ball on the floor. Great job breaking the defense, creating contact against a bigger defender in Jameson Morgan, and having the strength, despite his size, to get an and-one situation.
Hey, back in high school, he was a former football star, a defensive back, and run.
Hard position. Guys can do a great job stopping penetration, contest shots, and they're still able to make it. Turnover. That's an area that he has really struggled in, taking care of the basketball at the guard position.
And Denman off the miss. Bowers with another tip. Another hustle play by Lawrence for Baylor. Denman for three. Got it. Up by 15. Bowers make it 20. 20 points for Lawrence Bowers.
We don't have very much size, so a team that has a front line that can score, maybe like a Jared Sullinger or a Kansas team. Good move by English.
Kim English, the 6'6".
Well, Kim English can shoot the ball from the outside, but he can put the ball on the floor. Nice floater by Kim English.
Is right around 84. Actually, a little bit more at home. Things pretty much trending the way that they usually do. 16 other teams have tried and failed so far this year. Dixon with a floater.
And Michael Dixon started at
or hurt them in the end.
I think it really helps them because defensively you can't zero in on one guy. Now, late clock situation, what I do like is that
on the season, an 8-5 in Big 12 play. As for Scott Drew and his staff, three games remaining to try and find the right switch to make it into the NCAA. New Mexico State and San Jose State. For more information, log on to ESPN.com. Right now, let's go to the studio with Mike Yan. Mike?
You know, you hear a lot about Perry Jones and how great he is. And give him credit, he's a good basketball player. But, you know, our first option was to cut off Darius Dunn. But we also knew that Perry Jones could hurt us in many ways, too. And I just didn't want to be that guy that he hurt. You know, I wanted to do step up for my team, and I did.
Well, you finally got your first rope.
The color, the pageantry, pomp and circumstance, the Ides of March, and the exclusive coverage of the men's NCAA basketball championship continues from our nation's capital, Cincinnati of the Big East, against the Missouri Tigers. The winner of tonight's game was
predicated on steals. They are second in the nation in just under 10 per game. They're very active with their hands. They like to turn turnovers into points, and also they will run on makes or misses. They want to play an up-tempo game. They want to play a game in the 80s. And their leading scorer, Marcus Denman, has been terrific. Just about 17 points a game, but he's been even better in the postseason, Tim, at 21 points per.
Can Missouri show up?
Missouri with Denman
Dixon, Kim English, Ricardo Ratliff, and Lawrence Bowers. Guys that can really run the floor and play hard for a few minutes, and then they go to the bench. Dixon, Kashmir, Wright. They're as good as Wright is on a given night. Atlanta Braves, and Rick Pitino tutored him for a couple of years. And there's Mike Anderson, Melvin Watkins, the veteran assistant, and along with Terry Weimer and Antonio Petty.
Did not travel very well.
Ratliff.
That's going to be a very interesting matchup in the low. It's a different style of play.
English off the front iron. Ratliff, after Ibrahima Thomas could not reel it in, the loose ball, he picked it up and dropped it.
And they really swarmed to the post.
Bowers, baseline extended. And Mizzou out to a 4-point. Threw that one up like a grenade.
I think that was a lob to Thomas that he didn't recognize.
Denman. Mizzou out to a great start, a 7-0 run, and they lead it 9-2, just underway in a Let's take a look at the Infinity Coaches Spotlight, and what a resume built by Mike Anderson in his fifth year. Fastest Missouri coach to 100 wins, two Elite Eight appearances, and how about the performance he had with UAB a few years back? And I know Stormin' Norman Stewart has to be proud of him, too, one of the all-time greats who never got to a one of the hottest commodities in coaching. Very comfortable in Columbia, Missouri, and has made everyone aware of that of late. You see Phil Pressey coming onto the floor and knows so well. Pressey comes away with it, gives it up to Denman. All the way to the rack, high, arching off the glass. Oh, that was beautiful.
Well, Ian, you talked about it in the open about Imposey, too. This is what they do. Denman putting it high off the glass. And he called his team out, said they weren't playing with enough energy on either end of the floor. And that's, you talk about one thing that you have to have in playing for Mike Anderson, that's it. There it is. They're one of four teams in the NCAA that has five guys.
Just as I mentioned that, he turned it over. Got his pocket picked by Pressey. Dixon answers right away. Welcome to the scramble from Missouri.
We said yesterday, if he comes out of the ball game, we'll know why.
Moore with the rejection, and Dixon with the three ball.
Michael Dixon just under 40% from
Lewis Jackson touchdown at the start of our broadcast. Nice work by Bowers, a little show and go by Lawrence Bowers. The Bishop, right back in the game. Count it, he's got 11.
Well, Kashmir Wright, 35%, and he's getting sucked up in the pace of the game that Missouri wants to play, but they've got the 5-point lead.
Ratliff answers with a tray.
A sudden now.
Just lost his dribble that time to Bishop. 3-on-1 now, Dixon.
Oh, really nice decision to look off that time by Bishop.
And a timeout. Cincinnati with a very balanced scoring in this game. Yancey Gates stepping outside.
Three of his 5 points. Larry Davis, the three-point play the old-fashioned way. And then Kashmir Wright has settled into this game nicely, Tim. He leads the way with 9 points. Cincinnati to play against this type of defense and have only four turnovers to this point. Nick Cronin has to like that number.
The only player in the Big 12 averaging 15-plus points while shooting at least 50% over.
Comes by it honestly. His dad, Mike, played at San Jose State. When he left, he was the all-time assistant.
Michael Dixon, senior, so he is the junior. And when he did, as you mentioned, graduate.
Well, been a lot of old-fashioned three-point plays for Cincinnati in this.
Kilpatrick. Oh, how about Thomas on the glass? Oh, yes! Counted and a foul. What work by Ibrahima. Heels just a bit.
Well, you can take a look at it. This zone pretty compact, but they're matching up against shooters. Good rotation. Cincinnati's got the length to get out to people.
Go, 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 go. 22-9 run for Cincinnati.
Cressy and Dixon in the backcourt trying to create against that zone, find a crack in it. Underneath, just a tough take for Bowers, engage the rebound.
Quick outlet. Kilpatrick gets it back, a step-in three, not there.
Too early, gives Missouri a chance.
Indeed. Denman wants to take advantage. Well defended by Gates. Cincinnati closes the half on an incredible run to take control of this game. 39-28, 23-9. With Mike Anderson of Missouri.
Mike, your team averaged 81 points per game in the regular season. You only have 28 here in the first half. How much difficulty did Cincinnati's defense give you in the half court? What's the remedy?
Well, I think it's probably a combination of us not executing, not making shots. I mean, we had some open looks. They went to that zone, and we didn't knock shots down. At the same time, I think the rhythm of the game is to their liking. We've got to pick the tempo up.
Good luck.
Okay, thanks.
Dixon off the ball screen by Thomas, and a tip-in by Gates. Well, Ibrahim Thomas just set a huge pick.
As I said, this is one of the poorest.
9 minutes and 32 seconds now since the end of the first half and the opening moments of the second since Missouri scratched from the floor. But numbers now for Missouri. Flip Cressy leaves it for Denman.
Thomas George.
The trailer knocks down the tray.
That's one of the few good looks that he's had, and that loose.
Yeah, you're going to join me for that yoga class, aren't you, tomorrow morning? Get coverage of the Division
I. Four. Be part of the sleep study program tomorrow.
Bowers gets the two to go. One thing, though,
and you know what, Tim? As a player, I just
look at English, just like that.
Yeah, and good. This is now looking like a little bit more energized.
We'll stop and go to get past Wright. Denman with the feet on the wing, and it's nailed. Denman with a beautiful dunk down to Ratliff. That was well conceived.
I don't understand how coaches keep their sanity in the league that year. I mean, you can't look any farther ahead than your next opponent.
Cressy with a floater, a little rain.
This is where you need your bench to step up, and they've answered the call.
Flip Cressy with a tray. And it's 52-44. Starters, Safford. The jump hook does not go. Again, a 50-50 opportunity. Cressy's got it. Flip getting it done. He was referred to by Mike Anderson, his old roommate, as Pablo. There he is again, the Mighty Might. He's got Safford with him. Bang! Zoom! Here comes Mizzou!
Well, Dixon that time falling asleep on the play. Deion Dixon, and what a nice
in the first half. Davis leaves it for Gates for a slam. Their offense makes shots. Cressy again. Oh, the iron unkind, doubt about it.
Especially when he can get to that left hand.
Heart and soul of the team. Let's go from downtown. 59-51. Brecklow again hustling on the defensive end.
Only 28% from three, so found money right there.
Michael Dixon back on the floor to Brecklow. And the follow beautifully done by Bowers.
Just followed right.
Safford. Nice move on his part. A little flash to the top and from the elbow puts it down. Each of their last six trips. Gates looking for a step out three.
Second three of the game for Yancey Gates, and that may have taken the heart out of Missouri.
Open the floodgates on Yancey's perimeter game. Him, he got three fouls in the first half, and then that fourth foul in this victory in the second round. Dixon gets it to go off the glass. 4:55. Dixon, nice maneuver, and a blow-by.
Michael Dixon.
Oh, nice pass, pressing to Ratliff. Flip doing it all. I remember Mookie Blaylock back in the day used to. Well, that's what Pressy's doing. Been like a gnat. Look at this laser pass. Flash impact. Ratliff.
I know Mick Cronin not happy with that. That's a quick 2 points off the press. Very fresh today, Tim.
Now, obviously, there's going to be a familiarity there, and it's going to be a little bit easier for the coaching staff to prep for that game.
Right. Fantastic game off the bench for Mick Cronin, as so many of the Bearcats did. And they punch their ticket and move on to the third round, as they will be meeting the Huskies of Connecticut on Saturday in an all Big East third round matchup. 78-63, sixth seeded Cincinnati gets past 11th seeded Mizzou. Gates was the story, 18 points, 11 rebounds, 7 of 8 from the floor.
I also think the story, too, the way Cincinnati was able to handle the pressure, did a good job, only 11 turnovers and 7 steals below the average for Missouri, so they just weren't able to generate any offense out of their defense.
There you see so much of the emotion expended in Saturday's matchup. And our thanks to all of you that were with us. Our final score, 78-63 for Lewis Johnson, Mike Janinski, Tim Brando. So long from Washington, D.C. We'll see you on Saturday. The Ides of March remain. Bye-bye, everybody.
Game in the second round is the 6-seed Cincinnati taking on the 11 Missouri in the West, and Yancey Gates and the Bearcats get it done. Larry Davis finds it.
I'll tell you one thing, Yancey Gates was big, 7-for-8. He was dominant. You know, they're coming off a 38-point blowout against Notre Dame. What a turnaround.
Gentlemen, thank you all for joining us. From your left to right, we've got Lawrence Bowers, Marcus Dimmon, our Director of Athletics, Mike Alden, and Kim English. We'll go ahead and let Mr. Alden begin.
Well, first of all, let me welcome everyone this evening and thank you for taking the time to come out tonight on short notice. Certainly, I know that a lot of folks have traveled distances beyond mid-Missouri, so we appreciate you taking that opportunity and being here with us this evening. The reason that we're here today is at 6:45 this afternoon, I learned that Coach Mike Anderson was going to be resigning his position as head men's basketball coach at the University of Missouri. Now, when we learned of that, we then talked about some of the plans for this evening, and that being getting together with all of you at 9 o'clock. But part of that as well, too, included making sure that we had some of our student athletes with us, and I'm certainly very pleased and proud that Lawrence, Marcus, and Kimmy were here with me here, but obviously we have other student athletes in our men's basketball program that are here as well too. But I appreciate these three guys taking the opportunity to be here with me. Let me talk initially though, and I want to talk a little bit about a process, some history, and then kind of where we are today, and then where we're going to be going from here. But I want to talk about the Mizzou job, and I want to talk about the job that Mike Anderson and his staff have done at the University of Missouri, which has been an outstanding job. And we are so appreciative of the job that Mike and his staff and their families have done for the University of Missouri. We've been blessed that he has been here with us for 5 years, and we wish him nothing but the best. We have the tremendous and highest regard for Mike, for our staff, and for all those people, in addition to our student athletes, that have made Mizzou basketball what it is today. And certainly it's very exciting of where we are today and where we'll be heading. But if we talk a little bit about the time frame that led to today, you know, folks have talked before about an opportunity to perhaps put together a new contract, a restated contract, a revised contract for Coach Anderson. I want you all to know that those discussions happened a long time ago. Those started 5 months ago. We've had those. Last night at a little bit after 5 o'clock, I received a telephone call from our general counsel's office that it indicated that they had received a request from a representative of Coach Anderson asking us, as the representative for Coach, for permission for Coach Anderson to be able to interview for and talk with another institution. In his contract, I'm digressing, but I think you all know there's language in that contract that requires that. I mean, this is the third year in a row that we've kind of gone through that, so we're used to that, and we know that, and Coach knows that as well, too, as well as our entire team does. And when I got off the phone after receiving that phone call, I called Mike, and we swapped phone calls. As you know, Coach had a memorial service for a dear friend of his last night in Tulsa, Oklahoma. And being respectful of the fact that he was mourning the loss of a loved one, I knew it might be a little time before we had an opportunity to talk. And finally, about 9:15 last night, Coach Anderson and I did have an opportunity to talk, and we did talk about that request that he had made. And he did want to talk to me about the fact that he was hoping that our leadership team at Mizzou would grant him the ability to be able to talk with another institution. And last night, Coach Anderson and I did have an opportunity to talk, and we did talk about that request that he had made. And he did want to talk to me about the fact that he was hoping that our leadership team at Mizzou would grant him the ability to be able to talk with another institution. I'd asked him to sleep on that a little bit and wait until maybe we can get together tomorrow. We had a really busy day today, which we did, up until about 12:30 this afternoon. And at 12:30 today, the Chancellor's office and myself, we visited with Coach Anderson on a conference call. And at that time, Coach Anderson asked us directly for permission to be able to talk to another institution. And as we talked about that for, 20, 30 minutes, just talked about various issues and things, we granted that permission at about 1 o'clock this afternoon. Don't hit me directly on that timeline, but it was about 1 o'clock. From that point, I received a telephone call at 6:20 this afternoon from Coach Anderson asking me if I could meet him in the office. The office is at about 6:45. I met with Coach Anderson at 6:45 today in his office, and he informed me at that time that he was going to be resigning his position from the University of Missouri as our head men's basketball coach. Okay, so that's what led us all the way up until that time today. 7 o'clock this afternoon, I know Coach met with our team. 7:15, our guys were very gracious to wait there so I could visit with them as well too, and I visited with our team today, a ton of games, in particular over the course of the last 3 years. And there's a tremendous amount of history in winning at a high level at the University of Missouri. Under Coach Stewart, and for a period of time, clearly under Quinn, and certainly what Mike Anderson has been able to do. And these guys are representatives of that. And so we're not...
Mike, was there a time over the last few days that you felt you had an agreement with Mike Anderson to remain the coach? And can you comment on the possibility that when he asked to talk to someone else, you all withdrew that contract extension and he didn't have the option to sign it?
Gabe, can we take that kind of in a two-part then? So let's start with the first one. Okay, so in the first part of that, I don't think any time you ever feel that you have an agreement with anyone, in particular, until there is ultimate approval by our board of curators. You know, I think those decisions on what people make, what Coach made in his particular situation, are decisions that he made for whatever reasons that may be. Was I hopeful and confident that he and I were going to be working together for a long time? I sure was. You know, I tell you, I've been fortunate to work with guys like Gary Pinkel for a long time, and I think he and I are going to work together for a long time, even more. I've been fortunate to work with a guy like Mike Anderson, and I thought I was going to work with him for a long time, like I have with Tim Jamison, like I will be with Aaron Erlewine, like I will be with Robin Pinchin and others. And so it's disappointing, certainly for me, because
Kimmy, Coach talked a lot about loyalty and family. With those in mind, what did he give you as the reason for leaving for Arkansas?
It was a special place to him, somewhere he spent 17 years. And we were his family, and I believe those words. And he made sure to let us know that we experienced an amazing run with him and some special things. And the Pressy boys won't stop being his family. Marcus Dimon, Lawrence Bowers won't stop being his family.
I've been hearing a lot of the different things about whether Coach Anderson was staying or if he was leaving, and I wasn't really sure. And I went personally and talked to Coach Anderson about if he was leaving, because I didn't want to hear from the media or I didn't want to hear from anyone else. I wanted to hear from Coach. And I talked to him, and he let me know that as of now, he was Missouri's coach. And He didn't plan on changing it. He told me it was a really tough decision that he made today. And personally, as one of his players and as Coach Anderson being my coach, I felt bad about it. But I play for Missouri, and I just want to try to continue to worry about our program and us moving forward.
I'm here to play for Missouri. And at the time, Coach Anderson was here at Missouri, so it was kind of me playing for both. And for Coach Anderson, you know, for him to resign and go play for Arkansas, it really hit hard with me. You know, I took it really hard, being that I've known him my whole life, pretty much. But, you know, like Marcus said, I play for Missouri. I mean, you can't dwell on the past. I mean, it happened. You know, coaches moved on, so hopefully Missouri can move on. You know, we always...
17 years means something. But more importantly, I was just looking at my teammates' faces. And just if anything, I would just letting them know that we're going to be okay. And that's the most important thing to me, is my team and the name that is on the front of my jersey every night.
Well, I really don't have that much to say. You know, Marcus and Kimmy said it all. But like they said, it was a lot of emotions. You know, deep down inside, you're mad, really disappointed. You know, why us? But
at the what you guys might have heard as far as trying to keep each other abreast of what might be going on?
Just in passing. We just talked in passing. Just have you talked to Coach? That was all, because Coach told us that he would speak to us before we knew anything 100%. So even when we seen it on SportsCenter, I didn't take it as 100% until we heard it out of his mouth.
A couple more for these guys and we'll let them go.
The same question that Mike Alden answered for any of you. How do you reconcile the statements your coach made over the last 2 weeks with him telling you tonight that he was leaving? Because he made it very clear that he planned to go nowhere. And Marcus, you said he even told that to you when you talked to him a couple days ago.
When he said those comments, I really felt that they were genuine. And A lot of things changed, and I guess Coach Anderson just felt that that was the best decision for him to make at the time.
All right.
I think we'll reconcile it by winning.
All right. Thanks a lot, guys.
All right, thanks.
We'll go ahead and reopen up the floor for all.